Give it up for Alan Moore.
Thank you, thank you. I just got back from traveling back home to see my family. And I don't understand why people lose their minds at the airport anymore. We've been traveling for 50 years, and there's always somebody fucking up the rotation. I don't understand. Like, they call by zones. Zone 1, zone 2, zone 3, zone 4. I have my book, I have my ticket, I have my information, and still there's always someone like, yeah, they call zone 2, I don't really know where I... You can't get on the airplane, ma'am. Not today. I've decided. You're not allowed. And there's this guy, and he really pissed me off, because he gets on the airplane, I'm seated, the people next to me are seated, the aisle over here, they're all seated, there's one left, the window seat, which is this gentleman's. So he gets on, and I'm going to do this pantomime, bring back my college years. So he has a McDonald's bag in this hand, a frappe in this hand, and his jacket and his carry-on luggage. He gets to the aisle, not before, but he gets to the aisle, and he does this. God damn it. Get up. So these people get up, and then he does this. And squeezes into the seats. Like, put down your fucking McDonald's. They serve airline food, goddammit. It's just as bad for you. I don't understand. And then they have these children. They should have a non-children airline. Are you with me, people? Oh my, I should know your children's names. I hate them. I hate your children. And every time you make them laugh or cry, I want to stab them in the face. In the name of Jesus. There's this one particular kid, his name was Michael, and he wouldn't sit down. His dad had to get on with the giant car seats. He's like fucking with it and trying to put it on. I'm like, can we please go? I want to get home. And Michael, please stop yelling. Michael, please stop yelling. They finally get him situated, and then we're getting ready to go, and he starts screaming, I want my iPad. I want my iPad. Where's my iPad? So I took mine out and I busted it over his head. Happy birthday, Michael. Fucking hated that brat. And can we also do this? Can we put people under citizen's arrest if they're over 40 with a ponytail? Men and women both. Just cut that motherfucker off. Look what I did. I'm going bald. I shaved my head while listening to Britney Spears because I'm trying to keep it real. And I was... listening to this new Britney Spears song, it's called Work Bitch. Have you guys heard this one?
Yeah.
And the lyrics are like, you want a Maserati? You better work, bitch. You want a beautiful body? You better work, bitch. Can we start small? For those of us that don't have those items at hand, you want to pay your rent? You better work, bitch. You want a good credit score? You better work, bitch. You want to kidnap a van with no windows? You better work, bitch. So, I read about this guy on the internet, and his name is Clive Palmer. Please remember this name. Clive Palmer. He's a billionaire. What he's decided to do with his money is he's going to do Jurassic Park. For real. He has scientists working the clock to create Jurassic Park. They made 3 goddamn movies, sir. It didn't turn out well. I don't understand. Never in my 30-some-odd years of walking this planet have I gone, you know what this place needs? More dinosaurs. We need more dinosaurs. We throw a fit when a bird shits on the window. Can you imagine a pterodactyl shitting on your Subaru? I don't understand. I feel like to have that much money to be a billionaire, you should be able to fill out a test. Question number 1. Will you use your money to fund recreating dinosaurs? You are not allowed to be rich, sir. Please continue out your way. So, I am so glad the holidays are over. For real, I can't take it anymore. I can't stand behind any more people with a Santa hat on arguing with people at Starbucks over pumpkin spice. Yeah. It's almost like you'd rather do the time for murder than stand behind them anymore. And we've all been in the line. You've seen the menu. How do you have questions when you get to the cashier? I don't understand. Also, we as a people are getting dumber. I want everyone to realize that and take that in. I love America. I'm rah-rah America. I'll defend it till the day I die. But selfies in the dictionary, you guys. Selfie. Do you know what that means? That means in a few years we're going to have spelling bees. And it's going to go something like this. Madison, because they're all going to be named Madison. Madison, please spell selfie. S-E-L-F-I-E. I'm sorry, that's incorrect. Jennifer, that'll be new. Will you please spell selfie? Hashtag S-E-L-F-I-E. That is correct, Jennifer. Thank you guys, you've been great.